What's going on, guys? Awakening Gaming, I'm back here with another Python for Hacking video. In today's video, we're going to be going over how to create a basic keylogger in Python, so if that interests you, make sure you stick around. While we're making today's video, we will be going over a few things, like how to download a new Python package with pip. We're going to learn how to import that package into our code, and we're going to learn how to make user-defined functions. So let's go ahead and get into it now. So the first thing we're going to do is come over here and go to our command prompt, and we're going to pip install pynput. And I already have everything installed, so it's not going to do that for me, but yours will download. And then we're going to come over here, and our first line of code will be our import statement. So we're going to import pynput. And then the next thing we're going to do is from pynput.keyboard, we're going to import a few functions, one called key and the other one called listener. And that'll do it for that section of code. So the next section, and by the way, I'm using Jupyter Notebook, but you can use idle or a text document to do the exact same thing and then just turn it into a .py afterwards. So the next thing we're going to do is set up a couple of variables, one to keep count of how many keys we have pressed and one to keep count of the keys that we actually pressed. So we're going to create count. And we're going to set that equal to nothing. And our next variable, we're going to set up keys, and we're going to set that equal to an empty list. And that'll do it for all of our variables. So the next thing we're going to do is start on in a user-defined function. So we're going to define on press. And we're going to take the variable key as an input. And we need to set our variables that we just set up there to global. And that's going to be keys as well as count. So for keys.append and any key we press. So what that's going to do is take any of the keys we press and append it to our keys list. And then we're going to set our count to plus equals 1, which is basically just going to add 1 each time we press a key. It's going to add 1 to count, and it's also going to add the key that we pressed into our keys function, our keys list rather. And then we're going to, for debugging purposes, we're going to print the key that we pressed. So we do that like this. And we do dot format and key. So basically what this is going to do is for every key that we press, it will say, so say we press the A key, it'll take this and format it as the key that we pressed. So it'll say A pressed. If we press B, it'll say B pressed. It's just formatting this to be whatever key we pressed. And then we're going to go if count, if I can type today. If count is greater than or equal to 10, and you can change this number up, you can set it to 1, and every single key that's pressed, it'll log, or you can do it in batches like I'm doing here, so every 10 keys that are pressed, then it will do whatever we're doing. So you can play around with that number yourself, do however you want to do it there, and then we'll set count back to equaling nothing. And then we will write file, which will create that function here in a moment. And that will take keys. And then we'll set our keys list back to nothing. We'll set that back to an empty list. And that's it for our own press keys. So now we're going to define write file. And of course, that's going to take our keys. And then we need to with open. And then you can name this whatever you want to, but I'm just going to name it log file, log.txt. And then we need to set that mode to append, like so. And then we want to make a name for it as f. So every time we call opening this log file, all we have to do is reference it as f. So then for keys, or for key in keys, so for each individual key in that list of keys, we want to try a is equal to key.character. And if so, then f.write. So basically what that's going to do is it's going to take our keys character and set it as K, and then we will write that K file. We'll write each individual character. Except for attribute error. And then if the key is equal to key.escape, so you need to make sure you capitalize this K here. Key.escape is a function of pynput for our, meaning that it's the escape key, basically. I'm sorry, this should be key.space. And then f.write. And instead of writing that out, what we're going to do is we're going to, that's a break character, that's basically break in Python. So instead of writing out spacebar, it's going to actually create a space. And we could continue on like with the backspace key instead of printing out backspace, we actually backspace out the previous key that we entered in the list and so on and so forth. But I'm going to leave that for you guys as homework. And that will be the end of that function. So now we need to define own release. And it's also going to take key. And this is going to be a pretty simple one. If key is equal to key.escape, we are going to return false. So basically what that's going to do is if we hit the escape key, it's going to end our program for us. And then now we need to set up the main. So with listener on press is equal to on press and on release is equal to on release. And we want to set that as listener. And then listener dot join. So now if we run our code, we can see that if we type everything will be saved into our file. Then we hit the escape key. We can come over here and look at our log.txt file. I already had some stuff in here previously, but if we come back and we delete our log file, then we can refresh and run the code again. Hit our escape key, come back to our log.txt file, please subscribe. So, that's it for this tutorial. If you did like this video, please consider subscribing and giving me a like on the video, leaving comments if you have any questions or concerns, and I'll go back through the code slowly so that way if you missed it, you can get everything again. Alright guys, have a great day, and I'll see you guys in the next video.